Imagine taking your family to one of your favorite theme parks and shelling out big bucks to get in. You have been planning the excursion for a few months, and now the big day is here. You wake the family very early and pack them into the car. The excitement is building as the entire family heads for Six Flags. You have been to this popular theme park once before and you remember the lines being extra long. Today was no different. It takes you about 20 minutes from the time you purchase the tickets to the time you clear the entrance. You already have a couple of maps in your possession, with a few stops picked out to be on your must-see stops. The parents are determined to catch as many of the shows as possible, like Chart Toppers, Country Young Guns, and Texas Justice, while the kids seem to be interested in meeting the Looney Tunes pals and Looney Tunes party rocking dance party. The entire family is clearly biting at a bit to check out the roller coasters like Mr. Freeze, Reverse Blast, and of course the world's tallest roller coaster, the Shockwave. Then they heard about the woman who went plummeting to her death on the very same roller coaster. After asking the attendant to double check her safety bar, Rosie Esparza was advised that once she heard the click, she would be okay, and off the roller coaster went. Rosie never made it back to the finish with the rest of her family. She literally fell out of the speeding roller coaster to her death. Most coaster riders will tell you that there is some apprehension when the coaster pulls out of the station, but few will expect their ride to end the way Rosie Esparza's did. My heart goes out to the family, because they did not just lose their loved one, it happened right in front of their eyes. The tallest roller coaster in the world is now closed until a thorough investigation can be carried out.